Proposal of W3 next generation, so the modernization of Sokol is based on a new modern avionics, on a new weapon system and a new blade that determines an significant improvement of performances of the platform. In particular, as regard the avionics, this is based on the avionics already developed for the W69 helicopter, that incorporates new technologies, very easy to maintain, that will allow to this platform to operate for other 30 years to fulfill all the needs of the Polish armed forces according to the modern NATO standards. Finally, the new blade in composite, developed in Poland, will allow for a change of the flight envelope of the platform. That means an increase of the max takeoff weight of around 200 kilograms and an improvement in the speed of the helicopter. We are working on many programs in the helicopter sector, proposing a collaboration to Poland and the Polish armament group on the AW249, the new combat helicopter that we are developing for the needs of the Italian Army. We are working in the aircraft sector with proposing the Eurofighter program for the Polish Air Force as a new fighter, as well as we are starting to work on the fighter attack version of the M346, the Bielik aircraft that we have already sold to the Polish Air Force. In the land sector, we are working on the continuation of the Rosomac program, in particular for the possibility to integrate the Spike launchers and to give the anti-tank capability to this program, and to new ammunition, guided ammunition called Vulcano. The contract was signed on April this year, and according to the requirements, the deliveries will be in 2022. No, the W101 is assembled in our facility in UK. Svidnik participate to the production with many parts. I don't have with me the list, but we have already informed enough recently about all the elements, all the parts that are produced in Svidnik.